And greetings once again from Earth, and most welcome to another subliminal alien mind control indoctrination program, cleverly disguised as a Sky Factory 2.5 video. Feed the beast. Sky Factory 2.5. Yes. And as you can see, got some armor pieces that eluded the hell out of from all the mobs in the mob farm over there. Got a chainmail helmet. Got a imp skin jerkin. For the blast protection, fire protection 1, and protection 3 type of dealio sort of thing on there. That's pretty cool. Not like I really need it right now, because we have mobs pretty well under control in our Sky Factory world. Or the fact that they cannot spawn anywhere except for in the thingy over there where we kill the crap out of them. So, okay, and yes, in between regular episodes of this series, I did about a 2-hour live stream. I'm testing the live stream capabilities of my channel here. As you can see, we've got a little bit of change, especially when we come down here. We can see all the work I did in the live stream. Did all this tedious stuff. So I think right now, the name of the game is just collecting more materials and stuff like that. Now that I've got automated cobblestone generation, which I think is, yes, another thing that I was able to put together during the live stream. Got that squared away. One of the things I want to do is I've got some patterns all ready to go, stone tool patterns ready for making molds. However, we need more. We just got an ingot mold at the moment. We need a hell of a lot more gold. Need lots of gold for the making of the molds. It only takes, I think, 2 ingots to make most molds. But now that we've got automated cobblestone generation, yeah, I think what we can do here is start smashing the crap out of stuff. So I've got a couple extra compressed stone hammers ready to go, so we can just basically take these. Make 9 full stacks of cobblestone, and just love this X-compressor mod. And we can just basically make compressed cobblestone. Make a full stack of compressed cobblestone. Start smashing the crap out of this stuff and start sieving the compressed gravel with our heavy oak sieve there. And that's what I love about X-compressing, is it really kind of speeds up the tedious stuff that used to take forever in Sky Factory as far as the X-Nilo mod goes. You know, smashing and sieving of materials. X-compressing lets you do it with the compressed varieties, which, yeah, basically just multiplies your processing of cobblestone, gravel, sand, and dust by a factor of 9, which is cool. You cannot vein mine any of this stuff when you're using a compressed hammer on the compressed materials, but hey, you're still doing it, you're doing 9 at once, 9 blocks at once, so that's not too bad. No reason to get too greedy with the trying to make everything too easy. This X-compressing is sort of a little bit OP to begin with. It's real good for a YouTube series, though, because you don't have time to do all the tedious stuff that takes hours to do to work your way up in the Sky Factory world. It's nice to be able to do things a little quicker with this X-compressing mod. So, okay, so now take all this compressed gravel. And we can just, where is it, compressed gravel, ching, and now we've got ourselves a full stack of compressed gravel. Sweet, so we went through a whole stack, look at that, I got 6 diamonds out of that full stack of, compressed gravel, which is pretty awesome. I've actually sieved, full stacks of compressed gravel and gotten no diamonds, or got maybe 1, but I've never got as many as 6, so that's pretty awesome. And, okay, and, one other thing I meant to do last time that I forgot to do is put a stone barrel underneath this water here, and I'll show you why in a moment here. Let's see, do we have any smooth stone? Yes, we do. All we need to do, take 3 of them there, make some slabs, and just like the wooden barrels, we make a stone barrel. Just like that. And the reason I want to do that is we need a stone barrel in order to make obsidian. So, what we're going to do is we're going to come over here. We're going to bust out that block right there. I'm out of there. And we put the stone barrel right under there. We don't want rain getting in there, So I'm just going to take a... Oh, actually, I had a couple of slabs right there. But that was a full block on Las Vegas. It was just slabs. Oh, and what did I do? I accidentally just put them away. We just need one slab here. Bottom half slab. I'm just going to stick right there just to prevent the rain from going into this barrel here. And yes, pick those guys up. Grab up our bucket. Where is our bucket? We got two buckets. Those buckets now. Always nice to have a spare. And yes, we can pull the buckets of lava out of there, throw it in that stone barrel, and that gives us obsidian, which is a nice way to make obsidian. How are we doing? We've got about 6 buckets worth in there. We'll need 10 pieces of obsidian in order to make another portal. But I'm not too concerned with going to the nether just yet. I'm going to take 3 of these diamonds right now. Let's grab our ore smasher, which if you didn't watch the live stream, I will show you the ore smasher. It's a really cool tool. That's another one of those X-compression tools. Pretty awesome. Couple of sticks, a couple of crafting tables, and 1 single diamond. And yes, this is just an awesome thing because it will automatically craft up all these broken pieces and lay them out in front of you to be smashed, which is muy conveniente, if that indeed is a word. And let's see, yeah. We'll go ahead and show you how this thing works if you haven't seen it before. Just right-click, and it just lays them out just like that. And you can't vein mine with this tool, but as you'll soon see, it smashes them real fast. It just, yeah, barely takes any time at all to smash them, so. Alrighty. Crap, tons of stuff done, be a smash the hell out of. Let's make sure there's nothing else that will craft up, so we can put our ore smasher tool away, and now I think we can basically put all the broken pieces away. We don't have enough to craft up anything. Sweet, and we're left with all of this here dust. Yes, and the 3 diamonds, we'll get to that in a minute. But right now, I'm just going to craft these guys all up into blocks. Fantastical. Now we can basically start making more stuff and junk and junk and stuff. Let's start with the gold. We got 6 blocks of ore dust. That's going to give us 12 pieces of gold. And that should be, I think, enough to make most of these pieces that we need here. We need 39, almost 40 iron ore dust pieces. So that's going to be, what, 78 hooks of iron ingot right there. So that's going to give us plenty enough, I think, iron ingots to switch our tools over to iron tools, because we'll have plenty of iron ingots to spare for repairing those tools when their condition depletes. So, yes. Take these 3 diamonds. Here's the thing that I always like to have as soon as I can get it. We're going to grab that. We're going to grab 5 hunks of iron. And we're going to make ourselves a dolly. Make that just like that. Let's stick it back in there. I'm just going to take 3 diamonds. It's a little expensive, but we'll make a diamond dolly. And the great thing about the diamond dolly is you can pick up stuff, you know, like, for instance, we can pick up this better barrel right here and put it back down. The regular dolly will deplete over time and it will eventually break. The diamond dolly costs 3 diamonds. You may think that's expensive, but it never breaks. It's an unbreakable diamond dolly. And the reason we want that is because now we can move all of these storage chests down below here without having to worry about, let's see, where we're going to go, here like that. Yeah, without having to empty them out one at a time. We're all pain in the butt to have to do that. So yeah, because I would like to move most of this work area to the downstairs so we can get our little heads out of the rain. So let's move all these chests downstairs. You get a slowness buff when you're carrying those chests because they're heavy. So in fact, this one here, I think, can go up top because we're going to add another double chest above these, and we will have 8 double chests in total. Sweet, we've got all the chests moved now. Everything else I think is going to have to be moved individually. Let's grab all the books out of here and, oops. Let's just break that. The books will come out on their own. The bookshelf I'm going to stick over on the side here. And we'll just stick all our books back in there. We might put another one up there if we have more books. Eventually I'll have tons of bookshelves all over the place probably. And I think, also, let's, just grab one of these guys right now and just throw it down anywhere. Yeah, we got rain. Because, this is just, I want to make, a few more chests. Just three more chests. Another one up there. Here, a couple for pitching, pitching. Gonna grab some slabs. We're gonna kind of fill out the floor around here because we're on bottom half slabs. Make sure I'm gonna go all the way across here. Maybe even pick this guy up here because we're not gonna need that no more. Take that bottom half. Our bottom, rung. Ladder off, not that we're gonna have to worry about it unless we get mobs spawning down here. It really won't be an issue. And this is gonna be kind of our work area right over here. So, okay. Now, what we need to do is move all of our other stuff. So, let's, what we can do is we can go take those two out and put that guy down there. Let's put our stencil table over here because we only use it to make a pattern one time and we probably never need to use it again. Like once we've made all the patterns, we can probably destroy that thing. I'm going to put the part builder, right here. And tool station, next to it for now. And I think, that should probably be good, in fact. Just to make things look cool. Because, yes, we still have access to, all of the, patterns now. Well, as long as the pattern chest is adjacent to it, which it actually is if these were full blocks. They're slab blocks, but, that space in between, it doesn't mean they're still not adjacent. You can access the pattern chest, which is nice because you can hide it underneath things. We'll go ahead and put our flint in the tool station right now and put them down like that, flush with the floor. A couple of crafting stations here. This will be our new work area. And since these guys are adjacent to these, chests over here, we can access the items over there, which is kind of cool. So, okay, I think in the middle, I'm gonna grab up these here furnaces. And we're just gonna go patrolling, patrolling. In fact, I think what we'll do, yes, let's grab some more cobblestone right now. Make up two more furnaces. Sweet. I think I can actually bust these two out right there so we can have ourselves a little window. Look outside. Why not? And groovy, groovy, groovy. Let's hit F7 and see what our mob spawning on this stuff situation looks like. It looks like we could have some spawnage happening here. Let's see. There we go. Grab our torches. I'm not too concerned with it really at the moment, so. Just gonna put a couple of torches in the window right there, and that will spread enough light to prevent any mobs from spawning there. Probably stick one up there too, just to make sure the corner is good and sweet. So this is our new work area. And eventually, of course, what we really would like to have is elevator blocks. We need to get some ender pearls to make elevators so we can get up and down. A little quicker, but now we need to move all this stuff over here. So, and I think what I'd like to do is I'd like to move those guys kind of over here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want to move them right now because I don't want those barrels filling up with water. I'd just like to have at least eight barrels going there. And let's see, I think I'm going to have two more spaces there and one more space after that. The extra two spaces is going to be for a double wide chest. And that third space is where we're going to put our little quest book thing. So, let's see. Still carrying all this other crap on me. There we go. Let's grab ourselves. Oh, we already have a crafting station up there. Okay. Let's take these slabs. Let's see, in fact, you know what I think I can do? Put those other items right here. We're gonna start with the double chest. It's gonna go right there. We can take and pick this guy up now. And this guy. Put you there. And we'll put crafting station there. Now we need to fill in some holes over here. Grab a bunch of fences. I don't know, we probably need some more than that. Back up top, because we need to cover this. And let's see here. There we go. Oops. Didn't want to put that one there. There we go. As long as I get the one placed where I need it to, I'm cool with that. Okay, and let's nerd pull up here. Then we get our slabs up there. I guess that's close enough. That's all we need. We just need one up there that we can place the other ones against. Sweet, just like that. We don't have to worry about this one spot, about anything spawning there, because this is all getting moved. Up some more slabs. Okay, gathered everything up. Let's fill in our holes up here. We can pick this up. And that really clears out this whole area up here. Sweet. So, yeah, I think, in fact, you know, maybe I was right before. I think we need an extra spot over here. Because, yes, I forgot about our sieves. We need to put our sieves down, so two more there. Three more there. Fences. And yeah, I'm gonna do two. So I make that look symmetrical, make that look nice and pretty and cool. Make it look like it's actually structurally sound and actually holding something up. Okay, we'll put this guy, our achievement stand goes there. And we'll put our heavy oak sieve there. And we'll put our regular oak sieve here. And then the rest is going to be our composting barrels. Sweet! So now we've moved that whole thing over here. Excellent. This chest here, I think we can put all of our tree stuff in there. And you see, now we can take all these saplings, I think. Everything that is a seed or is not already a food thing, silkworms can go up there as well. And sure, the leaf blocks, because we're going to use those to make dirt. It'll take us a couple of trips, I guess. Move all this stuff up here. This is all going to be tree farming type of stuff. We'll all go in this chest up here. So, saplings. In fact, I think we can start making some dirt already, because we've got way more saplings than we need. We need to have almost 5 stacks of it, so whole stack, we'll do 8 barrels. 8 saplings per barrel. We'll compost to make a piece of dirt. So now we're getting organized. Now we're starting to get some kind of organizational type of thing. Looking like it's sort of almost happening. I think it's sure I will take the mushrooms and put them up the slimy sapling, why not? Witchery stuff, I don't know where I'm gonna put witchery stuff just yet, but the bone and the dirt, bone meal stuff that we use for growing stuff, this is all gonna be mostly just already made food sort of items. All of enchanting. Some of this other weird stuff, I think. And the pink dye, I don't know why that's there. I'm gonna put that up top. This up top maybe is gonna be our magic stuff for now. Stuff I don't know where to put just quite yet. Put all this stuff up here. Sweet, hey. Dirt. We'll keep on making dirt as time goes by with this stuff too. Stick the dirt and the box over here. Sweet, sweet, sweet. So that gets all that stuff out of the way. Let's vein mine this up. And excellent. So now we just gotta continue making our ores. Oh, we've got some tin in there. Okay, let's get those tin ingots out first. I didn't know we had tin in there. We can pour out a 9 ingot block. That leaves us a few more, probably 3 more ingots. Okay, first thing I think I'm gonna make is actually this gold should go back in there. It's not back in there for now. 3 gold ingots. I think it's only gonna take 2 to make the cast for this your pickaxe head. Is it? Yeah, I left 1 ingot. So most things are gonna take just the 2 ingots. All of our molds will go down here. Let's grab up our stone shovel head, our sword blade, and axe head. I don't know about the guard pattern, if we really need to do that just yet. Are we getting our 10 ingots? We can make 5 more casts. We're done with the shovel. Now I'll do the axe head. That guy right hand. Sword blade. Where does that leave us? That leaves us with 4 ingots left over. Sweet. So, and I think, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take all of these parts here. I'm just gonna throw them away. We'll make more if we need. They're just made out of stone, and they're pretty useless items to have around. Once you've made your cast, you don't need that pattern anymore. So, okay, let's start with... let's grab all these guys up, actually. Put a new cast in there, and let's get the rest of these gold ingots out of there. Sweet, that's all the gold ingots, and I think now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna put a whole bunch of iron in there. Oops, I accidentally put my gold ingots back in, and I did not want to do that, so okay, let's pick this guy up. We do have some ender pearls on us, so I'm going to take, let's take a stack of string here. Make some wool. And we really only need 2 elevator blocks right now. Plenty enough for that. And let's see. Let's go ahead and put her I guess we might as well stick it right there. Why not? Put another one right above it. And now, we can get up and down much quicker. Excellent. Well, all this iron is melted, and okay, so let's make ourselves an iron sword blade. Sweet. Let's throw our axe head pattern in there. Shovel pattern. And pickaxe head. Yeah, I think now we can go ahead and put our ingot cast back in, and we can put the rest of these casts away for now. So, sweet, let's head back downstairs. And now, first thing we gotta do, we have to have a fully upgraded, or fully repaired, tinker tool. Before we can repair it, or before we can change the parts on it, so let's see. This is going to need a cobblestone repair. Excellent. So sweet. So now, first thing, let's grab our sword. And we just put the new part in there, and now we have done upgraded the hell out of that into an iron tool now. We'll do the same with our pickaxe. And we get to keep all the upgrades and everything else that has leveled up on that tool, which is the thing I think is so awesome about Tinker's Construct. The axe head. Sweet. So, awesome. So now we've got iron. So now we've got iron on all three of these tools. I think that adds maybe a little bit of durability to them. And at least it takes the mining level now on our pickaxe goes from stone to iron level. Anyway, you know, we could mine ore blocks. Not that we need it for mining ore blocks, because that's not how we get ore in Sky Factory. But sweet, so that's all. Created there, and we can take and put these guys away, we can put this stuff away, and I think, in fact, let's put some of these other tools and things away that we don't need to be carrying around, and yeah, pretty much now we've got a little bit more organization going on here, and I think, we'll probably end the episode there. In between episodes, I'm going to go ahead and, look at all this nice open space in here now, it's so much nicer, but I'm going to go ahead and just, melt down some more of these ores and make more ingots, and in the next episode we'll start working towards getting ourselves some automated machines and maybe start generating some power. So if you enjoyed this episode, please hit that like button, comment, share, subscribe, and always obey your alien overlords, or you will be probed in your bunghole. Yes, yes, yes. Once again, this is Alien Pet 13, signing off. Probably later.